Hi everyone and welcome back. So in this video, let's cover all the rest of the things in this component. So here we have created this header component, hero component we have to build, and now we are coming to cover this title list component. Okay, and in the search bar also we have the same kind of system. Like if I search for Terminator, then it is also showing some same kind of tiles, right? So these three, all these list components are kind of same. These have an item list and the item component inside it. So you can see the list component and then list item. Okay, so these are kind of same which we have drawn here. Okay, coming back to the code here, now we have the header component which is doing perform search. Now let's coming to this search result component first. So search result component or the title list component, both are going to be same. Here what you have is, here you will be making an API call, here you already have a data, that is the only difference. First let's create this title list component. So we can import it from the components, and let's say that we are creating it there itself, title list. Okay, so title list inside component we have created one component, title list.js. What it is going to have is list items. Okay, this is again going to be a functional component, so we can copy few things from here, title list, and then we'll change it. Okay, you can call it as a title list and export default title list. Okay, now what do we have? We can have a API key which we can place perform search here. Perform, you can say a load content, because here we are going to load the content. Here we have some kind of a state data, and another thing is we can have another property loaded. When to show the data, once the loading is done or we have the data loaded, initially will be false. Writing functional component is always fun. Okay, so here we want to load some content based on the props which we are getting. So we are getting title and the URL. Based on this, we are going to make an API call. Okay, so in class based component, we write component did mount. Here we can just write use effect. If you want to make a API call, now we can decide based on what dependency you want to trigger that API call again. For now, let's make the dependency empty. And here, whenever your component is getting unmounted, then this function will get triggered. But for now, we can actually call load content. And here in the load content, we will be passing two things, props.url and props.api key. I mean, at least the props.url. So here we are getting two things from the parent component, title and URL. So let's get this title comma URL. Okay, and here you don't need to pass it. Okay, here we'll be passing title comma URL, at least URL. Title is just only for display. So in the load content, we can call props.url, and we can trigger this again if the URL is getting changed, but that will not happen. Maybe you can define the dependency props.url, but for one component, it is not getting change. Okay, here we are passing props.url URL, and now the same kind of Axios call we can put here in the in content. What this Axios call is doing, there is some kind of API key we already have. So this API key we need, we are passing it, and the URL we are already getting it from the function. We are making API call and we are setting set data instead of this dot set state. So data dot data, here I'm getting information, and if you are getting any error, then you can just console it. Okay, this is fine. So here we are actually using Axios to make an API call. So whenever the component is loaded, we will make this API call, and we'll just set loaded true in both the cases. If we are getting data, Now we got the data, we have to make the use of it. So in the return of this component, we will be returning it. So now you see this is the list, then there will be a list item component also. That list item component will render it. Okay, so what we can do is, here I just did a check, if data is there then only do these things. Okay, so you can just do a condition check. I mean, there are many ways of doing it. So data is there, or array dot is array, which is always going to be array because we initialized it with an array, and data dot length is greater than 0, then only render it this piece, because here we are returning some information. So in here we'll be returning something else. This is just a condition. So inside return, okay, we don't need to define it here. So this is a condition check which we'll be doing. That I think is not needed because we can just render it in the JSX. So this is what we are rendering from the component. This is a function closer. Let's create a boundary first. Okay, inside this we will decide what we are going to render. Okay, so here we can check the length and all. So before that, we can actually format this code a little bit, and here we can just const items. Okay, here we can actually loop onto the data which we have received, data dot map. Okay, data dot results which we have received. In the results we will have data. And we are running map onto this. So here we will have item and index. Okay, so what we are doing is, here we are checking. So we are getting item and index, and from that item we will be getting, so if I is less than 0, so here what we are doing is, if index is, so we are just fetching only 5 items. So you can do a splice also from 0 to 5. Here you can do splice, I think it will work, 0 to 5, then do the map. Okay, so you don't need to do an additional check here. Here what we can do is, we can now just get some values and we can return something from here. So we can just reformat it. Here what we are doing is, we are just getting items. So here I can just make it item. So item.name, if we are getting, then set this name. Item.originalName, item.name. And then we are passing this directly to the child component. Item.overview. I mean, we are just iterating on to individual item, and we are passing. So backdrop is a custom one, which we are getting from this item. We are getting path, title, name, and then we are returning this. So in the items, we actually got all the array values. Now, finally, what we can do is, we can just render everything inside this item. Okay, so this is going to be now simple, straightforward. Okay, we already have a boundary condition. Okay, so what we got is, we already rendered the items, so we can print that in the single curly braces. So it will render all the items here. So item is another child component which we are going to have, that will take care of the mouse over of individual item. So that I will have in the partials. item.js. cool. So I loop onto it. I just need to check splice would be enough, or splice or slice. Okay, items index backdrop, and I got the list of items. I'm rendering it here. You can add your custom classes, and we will be rendering this. So this, we can wrap it around this. So what we are saying is, once loaded is true, then only go here and render this. Okay, why it is complaining? I think we need to, if we are doing this, then I need to again wrap it inside fragment, because this should have one common parent component. So this way you don't need to introduce additional divs if you are writing something like this. Okay, so this is my title list component, and you can see on the page load itself I'm making this call based on the URL I'm getting. I'm getting some data, I'm setting that in the state here. This data I'm iterating, and based on that I'm getting some kind of a list of items component, child component, and I'm rendering it here. Okay, similarly there is another component which is search result. Search result component is just rendering on some of the props data which it is receiving. So we can create that in the partial. This component is receiving some data, so I will just copy few things. Search result. So it doesn't have any local state and all. It will be receiving some prop data. So here I will be receiving data, and based on that I will be doing performing some action. I don't have a local state and all. So here we are going to do the same thing which we have done in the list item. This thing, data.result.splice. So here I got ghost items, data, whatever you wanted to name it, data.result.splice, and then map it is doing, and key item, because here also we are going to use that list item component, and then while rendering it we are going to use same kind of rendering mechanism. This is what we will render from here. Here we don't have a loaded property. We can just do, if data is there then render this. If data is there, or data dot length, because this is coming as an array, greater than 0, then render this props.title. We don't have, so here we can see whatever you are actually searching. Search results, we have the class name items. So here we are actually returning items data. So from parent component we got this data, we are iterating on it, and we are just looking for top 5 results, and we are just returning the 5 item components and then printing it here. Okay, so this is our search result component that we are rendering here. Search result component, we can now import it. So it is coming from partials. Similarly, there can be a hero component which is static one. Okay, so this is component organization we have done. These are 5 child components. Same kind of, based on URL you are passing, they are making an API call, changing the URL and fetching the data. So these are 5 independent child components which are fetching the data and showing it to us. And we are showing the title in the bold icon. You can see these are the titles we are passing in. Every child component is making call and getting the 5 results out of it. Similarly, we have a search. So when you click on search, it is making an API call and getting this data. So this search component, what if I'm changing it? Will it make API call? Yes, it will make, right? So dark. You can see now this search component and the search result. So whenever the term is getting changed, every time when you perform search, again an API call is being made, you got a new set of data, new set of data is being passed to search result, new data is getting reflected through the item components we have here. Okay, item component we can actually create, that is nothing but displaying information. So item component will be straightforward. I can just put it here. This is a common component, so we can create it outside, or I think we already created some file. No, item.js. So what it is going to have, const item, functional component, and what it is doing is it is just returning some JSX with the information which it is receiving in the props. Before that, you can import React. Okay, and we are doing export default. Cool. Now in this JSX, we are just returning the props data which we have received from the parent component. So similarly, like props.title, score, overview, backdrop, the background URLs. Okay, now this can be imported in this item list. Here we are getting the item. So this is pretty much, okay, we have covered almost all components. So in the next video, we will just see the component organization with a demo and see what we have done, what all different events we are doing, what data it is being passed, okay. Thanks everyone.